Welcome to the lecture series of signal system. In this lecture, we will discuss the basic definition of a system, means what a system is, and start some types of systems. In many types of systems, we will go through static and dynamic systems, and then we will discuss some other types of systems in the subsequent lectures. So, the basic definition of a system, what the definition says is a system is interconnection of components, or we can say that it is interconnection of subsystems, but these components cannot be connected in any fashion. They need to be connected in a regular, in a meaningful manner, so that they can produce the desired output what we need. Obviously, the system used to transform some input signal into more useful signal, which is called output signal. Obviously, output is more important, more useful than input signal. That's why we are transforming this input signal to a meaningful output signal. So, the system is basically meaningful interconnection of components, or we can say that it is meaningful interconnection of subsystems. They are connected, the subsystems or components are connected in a meaningful manner, so that they can produce a desirable, useful, a needful output. So we will go through the definition. System is a meaningful interconnection of components which accepts some input and transforms it into a meaningful, or we can say that transforms it in a more useful signal, which is called output signal. So systems, by another definition, says that system is a means of transforming some input signal into a more useful output signal. Systems are broadly classified as signal was classified. They are continuous time systems and discrete time systems. What the continuous time system is, the system which transforms a continuous time input signal to a continuous time output signal. Then this system is called continuous time system. As given here, there is a system which transfer function is t, it accepts some input xt and produces, or we can say that it transforms xt into the yt. Obviously, yt is more useful than xt. And generally, the input and output signals are denoted by an arrow going inside the system. This is input signal, and arrow going outside of the system. This is output signal. In the context of signals and systems, generally input is denoted by XT and output is denoted by YT, which indicates that XT is transformed into YT. So we can indicate as XT is transformed to YT by an arrow, or we can write it as YT is equal to transformation of XT. So we can write it as YT is equal to T into XT. And the other type of signal is discrete time system. Means the system which transforms or which accepts discrete signals at its input and produces some discrete signal at its output, or we can say that the system which transforms discrete time signal into some more useful discrete time signal. As we have seen in the continuous time system, the YT and XT can be related by this function. Yn is equal to T into Xn, means transformation of Xn into Yn. And other type signal may also can be seen also, like if the signal accepts continuous time signal and produces discrete time signal, or system may accepts discrete time signals and produces continuous time signals. Such type of systems are called hybrid systems. They can process both type of signals. They can process continuous time signal, they can accept continuous and produce discrete time signal, or they can accept discrete time signal and produce continuous time signal. Such type of systems may be treated as hybrid systems. There is some more classification. These continuous and discrete time, both type of signals can be classified as, there are many types of systems. One of them is static and dynamic systems. The first system we will study is static and dynamic systems. So static systems, generally called instantaneous or memoryless systems, are those systems which output depends only on the present value of the input signal. So the output is dependent over only the present value of the input signal. So if the output depends only at the present value of the input signal, it means that this type of system does not needs any memory to store the previous value of the input signal or previous value of the output signal. It only depends on the instantaneous value of the input signal. That's why static systems are also called instantaneous systems. Such that given examples are here, yt is equal to xt. If input is given at t equal to some time t naught, then means input is xt naught, then output will depend only at this value. It will not take any past value of the input or any future value of the input. That's why this system is also called instantaneous type system, and it does not needs any memory to store the values of previous values of the input signal or future value of the input signal. That's why this type of systems also called memoryless systems. The dynamic system. A system is said to be dynamic or memory system if its output depends on past or future values of the input. So, because the output of the system is dependent over past values of the input also, or we can say that it may depend at the future values of the input also. So to process or to accept the previous values of the input, such type of systems needs memory to store the previous values of the input. That's why these systems are also called memory systems, because they need to be stored the previous data also, and also they can process present data of the signal. Examples are given here as yt is equal to xt minus 1. If we start giving input at t is equal to 0, then what will be the value of y0? It will be x of minus 1. Minus 1 means it is the previous value of the x. Before t equal to 0, this signal will occur x minus t. So it is the previous value of xt, and this is the present value of the output. So it means that this system depends on the previous value of the input. That's why this is called This is in the class of dynamic systems. The second example which says that yt is equal to x of t plus x of t plus 2. At t equal to 0, we can test this system. At t equal to 0, y of 0 is equal to x of 0 plus x of 2. At t equal to 0, this signal takes value x of 2. It means that this is the future value of the input signal. X2 is the future value of the input signal, whereas x0 is the present value of the input signal. It means that output of the signal depends on the present value of the input and also at the future value of the input. That's why this system is a dynamic system, or we can say that this is a memory system. Next example, these two are same as previous two examples, except they are given in the discrete time domain. One note is given here that systems described by the differential or difference equations are dynamic systems. Why they are dynamic? Because if we want to calculate, if we want to solve any differential equation, then we need to know the initial values of the variables. We need to know some initial value of the variables. For that, some initial conditions need to be stored to solve the equation. To store the initial conditions, to know the initial values of the variables, we need to a memory to store their initial values. That's why all the systems described by a differential equation, or if the system is discrete time system, then it may be described by difference equations. So these systems are basically dynamic systems or memory systems. Some more examples are there. Go through these examples. The given example here, yt is equal to xt minus 3. We have to test the given system, whether it is a dynamic system or it is a static system. So to test the system, we have to know whether the output of the system depends only on the present input, or it is dependent over previous value of the input or future value of the input. So for that purpose, we have to put some values of the t, we have to take some random values of the time, such that for the first question, if t is equal to 0, then y0 will be equal to x of minus 3. We consider time t equal to 0 and output of the system is dependent on x of minus 3. So with respect to 0, minus 3 is the past value of the input. So this system is which type of system, dynamic or static? This is a dynamic system, because output of the system is dependent over the previous value of the input. The next one is yt is equal to x of 2t. If we take t is equal to, suppose t is equal to 1/2, if t is equal to 0.5, then y of 0.5 is equal to x of 2 into 0.5, which will indicate that x of y of 0.5 is equal to x of 1. With respect to 0.5, at time t equal to 0.5 second, the input x1 means value of t is 1 here. It means that the given system at some value of t is dependent over future value of the input. Because with respect to t equal to 0.5, x1 is the future value. It means that if system depends on the future value of the input, then it's clearly can be said that the system is a dynamic system. Again, the third question is, yt is equal to d2xt square by dt square plus 2xt. As note is given here, if the system is defined by a differential equation, then this system is a dynamic system. It means that this will be a dynamic system. Again, this system, the output is, we can test that this output of this system is dependent over future value of the input, because if we put y n equal to 0 in this system, we will get y0 is equal to x of 2. It means that the present input output of this system is dependent over future value of the input. It means that this is a dynamic system. Another example, yn is equal to x square n. In this system, for each and every value of the input, the output of the system will depend only on the present value of the input. You can check by taking any random value of the n. So for every value of n, the output of the system will depend only on the present value of the input. That means that this is a static system. Next example is yn is equal to xn minus 2 plus xn. Clearly from here it can be seen that if n equal to 0, then it will become x of minus 2. That means the system output of the system is dependent over the previous value of the input. It means that the given system is a dynamic system. So this is all for this lecture. In the next lectures, we will discuss some other types of systems like causal, non-causal systems, time variant, invariant, time invariant or time varying system, static, stable system, unstable system, linear, non-linear system. Many are there. We will discuss them one by one in the subsequent lectures. For this lecture, this is all for. Thank you.